How many senses do we have? Actually, we have so many senses, includes visual or sight, olfactory or smell, gustatory or taste, vestibular or balance, auditory or hearing, tactile or touch, and a proprioception or the body awareness. Sensory organs, specialized receptors for detecting environmental cues. A sense organs transforms energy from the stimulus into an action potential. Perception of a sensation is determined by which part of the brain receives the action potential. Classification of receptors, we have the exteroceptor and an interoceptor. The exteroceptors receive information about the external environment. The major sensory receptors types are the vision, hearing, balance, taste, smell, and skin. The interoceptors. Interoceptors, meaning receive information about internal organs. Includes heart, kidneys, bladder, skin, hormones, lungs, stomach, intestines, bone, and immune cells. The electromagnetic receptor, known as photoreception, that respond to light energy. The vision, the world around us is bathed in light. The sense organs that we use to sense light are the eyes. Photoreceptors means light sensitive receptor. Even some unicellular organisms have photoreceptors. An example is the dinoflagellates. Vision and invertebrates. Most invertebrates have some sort of light detecting organ. One of the simplest is the eye cup of planarians, which provides information about light intensity and direction but does not form images. Types of image forming eyes. We have compound eyes and single lens eyes. Compound eyes found in insects and crustaceans and consist up to several thousand light detectors called the matidia. Single lens eyes found in some jellies, polychaetes, spiders, and many molluscs. They work on a camera-like principle. Vision and vertebrates. The eyes of vertebrates are camera-like, but they evolve independently and differ from the single-lens eyes of invertebrates. The main parts of vertebrate eyes are the sclera, white, includes the transparent cornea, the iris, colored, regulates the pupil, the retina, which contains photoreceptors, and the lens, which focuses light on the retina. The human retina contains two types of photoreceptors, rods and cones. Rods are sensitive to light but do not distinguish colors. Unlike the cones, distinguish colors but are not as sensitive. Color vision. In humans, there are three types of cones, the blue cones, red cones, and green cones. Each type of cone is sensitive to a specific portion of the visible spectrum. The combined stimulation of these cones produces all the colors you see. As the graph shows, the sensitivities of blue, red, and green cones overlap to some degree. Because their sensitivities overlap, we are able to distinguish all colors.
Now for the hearing. Few invertebrates can hear. Exceptions include insects that have simply designed ears that allow the insect to hear calls of potential mates, rival males, or predators. For instance, moths can detect the ultrasonic sounds of bugs. Vertebrate ears originated as a balance organ, or labyrinth, a part of the labyrinth elaborated into the cochlea. Vibrating objects create percussion waves in the air that cause the tympanic membrane to vibrate. The three bones of the middle ear transmit the vibration to the oval window on the inner ear or the cochlea. These vibrations create pressure waves in the fluid in the cochlea that travel through the vestibular canal and ultimately strike the round window. The pressure waves in the vestibular canal cause the basilar membrane to vibrate up and down, causing its hair cells to bend. The bending of the hair cells depolarizes their membrane, sending action potentials that travel via the auditory nerve to the brain. The cochlea can distinguish pitch because the basilar membrane is not uniform along its length. Each region of the basilar membrane vibrates most vigorously at a particular frequency and leads to excitation of a specific auditory area of the cerebral cortex. Most invertebrates have sensory organs called statocysts that contain mechanoreceptors and function in their equilibrium. An an animal changes positions, platelets shift, disturbing cilia. In most terrestrial vertebrates, the sensory organs for hearing and equilibrium are closely associated in the ear. Several of the organs of the inner ear detect body position and balance. For instance, the horizontal semicircular canal tells you when you are turning your head from left to right. For the vestibular nerve, it sends signals from your balance organ to your brain. The cochlea, it controls your hearing. The utricle or otolith, it tells you whether you are upright. For instance, it senses the gravity. The saccule or otolith tells you when you are moving forward or backward.
Chemoreception, taste and smell. It responds to chemical stimuli in their environments that depends primarily on the senses of taste and smell. The perception of gustation and olfaction are both dependent on chemoreceptors that detect specific chemicals in the environment. The taste receptors of insects are located within sensory hairs, which are located on feet and in mouth parts. Taste, the receptor cells for taste in humans are modified epithelial cells organized into taste buds. Five tastes. Perception. They are sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and umami. Umami, you can find it in monosodium glutamate MSG. For example, is magic syrup, vitin, and many other. The smell. Olfactory receptor cells are neurons that line the upper portion of the nasal cavity. When odorant molecules bind to specific receptors, a signal transduction pathway is triggered, sending action potentials to the brain. On animals, many animals produce species-specific compounds called pheromones. Pheromones released into the environment carry information about territory, social hierarchy, sex, and reproductive state.
Now for the skin receptors, these receptors sense physical deformation caused by stimuli such as pressure, temperature, and pain. So this is three basic receptors. We have the mechanoreceptors, which detects physical change, the thermoreceptors, which detects temperature, and the nociceptors, which detect pain. For the mechanoreceptors, it has six types. It includes the hair plexus, or the hair follicles receptors, the Pacinian corpuscles, which is responsive to vibration, Meissner corpuscles, which is responsive to fine discriminative touch and vibration, the Merkel complexes, which detect shape, size, and texture, the Ruffini corpuscles, which register mechanical deformation within joints, more specifically ankle change, and the C-fiber LTM, low threshold mechanoreceptors, which detects pleasant and erotic touch sensations. So for the animals, most fishes has lateral line system, which contains mechanoreceptors with hair cells that respond to water movement. And this allows the fish to detect changes in current associated with nearby prey or predators. So these mechanoreceptors also help in their survival. And when they detect predators, they can avoid them earlier. Now for the thermoreceptor, which detects the temperature, it responds to hot or cold and helps regulate body temperature by signaling both surface and body core temperature. Now, we have cold receptors that mainly sense temperatures between 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, and touching dangerously hot objects higher than 45 degrees Celsius causes paradoxical firing of cold receptors, resulting in a brief cold sensation. So when we touch a very high temperature that is already harmful, our body feels a very brief cold sensation. Now we have here the thermoreceptors of fruit flies. So fruit flies are a great model for studying how the brain processes temperature, because even a small temperature change can be deadly to these tiny insects because they can't regulate their own body temperature internally. So fruit flies need a quick and efficient system for sensing dangerous temperatures and escaping. Although humans have more options for responding to uncomfortable temperatures, the brain's logic for response representing temperature is likely similar for both species. So let us look at this
picture. Look at these thermoreceptor neurons, which is located on the antenna of the fruit flies. So this one, the thermoreceptor neurons from the antenna relay temperature signals to the projection neurons or the PNs in the brain. So we have here the hot thermoreceptor neuron and the cold thermoreceptor neuron. So the hot thermoreceptor neuron detects hot temperature. So from a stimuli, it sends information to the projection neuron. So the cold pathway only receives cold stimulus from our thermoreceptors. However, our hot pathway does not only receive input from the hot pathway, but they are also affected by the cold pathway. That's why we have the intermittent temperature. Now, under cold conditions, the hot PNS are suppressed by the cold pathway and unable to activate. That's why it can only receive from the cold temperature. Okay, in warm-blooded animals, including humans, the autonomic nervous system plays a major role in maintaining body temperature by internally regulating heat production and heat loss. So when we feel hot, our body is doing its role in regulating our temperature. So from our thermoreceptors, it sends a stimulus that our environment is hot. That's why to our brain, it sends signals to our autonomic nervous system, and our body produces sweat in order to regulate our temperature. Now, have you seen those animals huddling when it's cold? It's because it's in order to maintain a warm temperature. Now, for the cold-blooded animals, they maintain safe body temperatures mainly by moving into locations of favorable temperature like shade or sunlight. Unlike the warm-blooded animals, which we regulate our own body temperature, they just move on other locations. For like snakes, they like dark, shady places for cool temperature. Now, for the pain receptor, they are the naked dendrites in the epidermis that respond to excess heat, pressure, or specific classes of chemicals released from damaged or inflamed tissues. Now, we have our thermoreceptors. However, for an extreme heat, we have now the pain receptors or any damage to our tissues. Now, these are called nociceptors. They help signal pain related to temperature, pressure, and chemicals, and only signal when the body has reached the point of tissue damage, and they sense pain through our free nerve endings.
So for review, the major sensory receptor types that were discussed a while ago is vision, hearing, balance, taste, smell, and skin.
Yay!